Hey, BC, Boris here. Yeah, I'm done with my box set series and I was thinking what to do today. So I decided to do another mixtape. You see the reel spinning in the back, and yeah, I was still in the mood for jazz, so I did a jazz mixtape. The whole mixtape is BlueNote based, and we're going right through it. First of all, Tank Mobley's workout, pretty well known, I think. Maybe I have to say, besides one, all of those BlueNotes are from the 75th anniversary series. I know there are a lot of discussions if they are quality-wise good or bad or what is better, so they might, originals might be always better, but I can't afford an original usually, especially not in Europe, so no chance to find something like that here. Those other pressings around might be nice, better, whatever, but they are also heck of expensive, and if I have to add shipping, then one single LP would be maybe $50 or something like that, and this is too much from my opinion. However, I think BlueNote did a pretty good job with those, and yeah. Workout Tank Mobley, the track I chose was also Workout, it's what you hear there. And this is pretty nice. Second, Horace Silver Quintet, 6 pieces of silver. And this is the only, not really original, but this is 47 West New York pressing. Don't know if this is really original or maybe a second pressing or whatever. So this was my only chance to compare to the 75th anniversaries quality wise, and I don't find much difference, I have to say. What I can say is these are a little bit louder, so I had to equalize the volume for every single recording. I had to turn that a little bit down. But besides that, not much difference. However, 6 pieces of silver. I chose the second track from the B-side. It's called Virgo, and it's a pretty nice album. Like it a lot. Opa. So maybe I can show you pressing. I'm not sure if YouTube will accept this in the back. We'll see. Next one, Thelonious Monk. Right here, see this 75th anniversary's come with that cover. I chose the track Straight No Chaser. It's first from the B-side. I don't have to say much about those, because let's say every single LP from that collection is a classic, so we're only talking about classics. Horace Silver again, Song for My Father, 75th anniversary, just the second track from the B-side, The Kicker, beautiful album. Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers, Moaning. And I chose Moaning as a track. excellent record. Love it. Next classic, something else. Cannonball Adderley, together with Miles Davis, Hank Jones, Sam Jones, Art Blakey. I mean, think about an original on that copy. It's insane what you have to pay. I chose One for Daddy O. Second track on the B-side. Dexter Gordon, go. Again, second track, B-side. Where are you? So Dexter Gordon is always good for the slow tempo on the ballads. Dexter Gordon again, Our Man in Paris, Bud Powell, Kenny Clark. Second track on the B-side, Stay Away to the Stars. Don't know if you recognize, but I rearranged my listening room. Took me yesterday the whole day. So, moved all the equipment to the window side. Now the speakers are a little bit closer together, but my overall space is limited. But I think it sounds better now and looks definitely better. Eric Dolphy, Out to Lunch. Here I chose second track from the A side, Something Sweet, Something Tender. Hank Mobley again, Soul Station, second track A-side, Dig This. As I told you in my last video, Hank Mobley is one of my favorite sax players and I absolutely love what he's doing. Mode for Joe, Joe Henderson, and I chose the track Black. The third one from the A side. Nice drum solo. The absolute classic, John Coltrane, Blue Train. First track from the B side, Locomotion. Was what I chose. Afro-Cuban, first track from the A-side, Aphrodisia, it's Kenny Dorham. Don't know why I kept the shrink here, I will remove it later. Yeah, again, I mean, what should I tell you about those? They are all classics and all very well known. Miles Davis, good old Miles Davis. I chose two tracks. I chose Kalo and Yesterday's. Again, I told you during the last video, I really love Miles Davis, but I really love his old school stuff. And this is exactly what you got here. Yeah, last but not least, Gil Mellé. It's a 10-inch. Which track did I choose? Don't remember exactly. I think it was Venus or Under Capricorn. Don't know exactly. However, also a beautiful, beautiful LP. Yeah, I think this was a pretty short one. However, you don't have always to to extend it to the max. So, hope you have a nice week, and see you next time, Missy. Cheers.